In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, all. Thank God for the gift of life today. We continue to pray for His providence and guidance upon our lives, and for the forgiveness of sins. I confess to Almighty God, you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that schooled through lengthened observance and nourished by your word, through holy restraint, we may be devoted to you with all our heart and be ever united in prayer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people and said, "Now, Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe, that you may live and may enter in and take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. Therefore, I teach you the statutes and decrees, as the Lord my God has commanded me, that you may observe them in the land you are entering to occupy. Observe them carefully, for thus will you give evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations, who will hear of all these statutes and say, 'This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people.' For what great nation is there that has gods so close to it as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are as just as this whole law which I am setting before you today? However, take care and be earnestly on your guard, not to forget the things which your own eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your memory as long as you live, but teach them to your children and to your children's children." The word of the Lord. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion, for he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word. He spreads snow like wool, frost he straws like ashes. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for other nations. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. May we stand for gospel acclamation. Glory to you, Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. To you, Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Glory to you, Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. Amen, I say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law, until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do so, will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus encourages us this morning not to be lazy about the laws. Yes, because can you imagine a state without a law? How chaotic it can be? How disorganized it can be? Or maybe a country without a constitution? It will be in disarray. Or can you picture or imagine if we don't have the driving course in California? Every person drives whatever it pleases him or her. You have no place to stop. That's nothing like a red line. That's not like a green line. That's nothing like a protected turn or intersections or the laws guarding the pedestrians. Or, you know, it would be very, very chaotic. So these are what laws do in the human establishments and organization. It keeps order, keeps the beauty, and then helps us get to our destination. What I mean by destination, what we aim at achieving in that particular establishment or venture we have entered. So every section of our lives, there are laws guiding them. There are biological laws, and there are natural laws that help us keep our environment in good shape, eco-friendly laws. So, and then also even bringing up our children, there are laws guiding parenting. And when you go against these laws, I bet you go against the beauty for which that was established. You go against the destination. You go against the gain for which that was established. And also, there are also laws guiding our spiritual life, our relationship with God. There are also laws guiding them. Even the Lenten season we have entered, there are observances, there are laws guiding it. So Jesus is calling up on us today. Please, my children, do not be lazy about the laws. And then do not teach others to like or love shortcuts. No, that destroys shortcuts. You want to get a degree, but you want to do it in a manner that you're not going to go through the normal route to that. You want to raise your children, you don't want to go through the normal route to raising them so that they will be responsible. When you did this, you teach others that, look, there is no need trying to go through the rigorousness that is involved in the laws. No, there is a way you can outsmart this and get what you want and then go your way. There's no need going through the normal route. No, listen to me. If you do that, you deny yourself of the lessons you need to learn while going on the established route towards that destination. And then you teach others too to destroy whatever has been put in place for the happiness and the joy of all of us. So let's have this at the back of our minds, especially in raising our children. You see, there is what is called a Pyrrhic victory. Pyrrhic victory is, yes, you have achieved what you wanted to achieve, or you have victory, but what you lost is higher than the victory you have achieved. That becomes a Pyrrhic victory. When we train our children this way, we may achieve what we want to achieve, but we have set a wrong precedence for them, and that will haunt the future. G- Jesus calls on all of us today. Because the Jews were like, he has come to abolish the law. He said, no, I have not come to abolish the laws, but to fulfill them and to make them look right the way they are supposed to be taken. Moses tells us in the first reading today, if you want to be happy in whatever you're doing, follow the law. If you follow the law, you'll be happy going through the process, and you'll be happy with the gain you will have at the end. So let us make a next effort. If you are driving, drive according to the code. If you are seeking a degree, the universities have their own laws and procedures. Follow them. If you want to have a good relationship with God, the spiritual laws are there. They may be difficult. Follow them. If you are raising your children, raise them in a way that they learn from you. That, look, this is what mom taught me. This is what dad taught me. If tomorrow, those things you are teaching your children, when they come out and say, this is what mom taught me, will you be proud to say, oh, I did that, I taught her, I taught him? Or will you be ashamed, oh, I didn't know this little kid will come out here and say this, and you become ashamed? No. Do it rightly. Heaven will receive the glory, and there will be salvation for all of us. We pray for the grace to be law-abiding citizens, not only here, but also heaven coming, because we are citizens of heaven too. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Praise and glory. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the prayers of your people, along with these sacrificial offerings, and defend those who celebrate your mysteries from every kind of danger, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feast with the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and on the words of charity, and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, and our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. May the heavenly banquet at which we have been fed sanctify us, O Lord, and cleansing us of all errors, make us worthy of your promises from on high, through Christ our Lord. Thank you for being available for the Mass this morning. Continue to be law-abiding citizens, both for heaven and for their country, America. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace, glorifying God by our lives.